Hello, I'm Rob McFadden. I'm here to talk about the challenges of needing to make your own schedule. Over the past couple of weeks, many Americans, certainly in the mid-Atlantic states, have been dealing with the fact that they're staying at home and forced to create their own schedules. There's no external forces necessarily creating a need for them to schedule themselves day by day. I've heard this consistently from both patients that I speak with and people in my personal life. I've seen a common error or stumbling block in terms of doing this for themselves. It's an overfocus on accountability. People become self-critical. People make it about something in their personal strengths or their willpower. When people step aside from this and focus on the following five pillars, they seem to do a lot better. Number one, prioritizing responsibilities and dreams. Building their schedule around what they need to do, but also what they want to do. Dr. Marty Horowitz in A Course on Happiness reflects on how happiness doesn't come easily. We need to keep our goals and dreams in our mind every day. This opportunity to create our own schedule is a wonderful way to build, focusing on our goals, on what could make us happy. Number two, being arbitrary. What I mean by that is just picking a time to get up, picking a time to have lunch, picking a time to exercise. People who are waiting for some aha moment on what the perfect time is or for some external force to come in and show them what they should be doing are still waiting on it. The people who at least are picking something, even if it's totally out of thin air, are doing much better in terms of generating their own schedule. Number three, being bold. Meaning, people who even tonight sit down, write out a schedule, and then tomorrow wake up and do it, even if it's clunky, even if it feels like it's not what's best. The people who are being bold and getting started, actually doing it, having some courage, are the ones who are making strides and generating a schedule for themselves. Number four, fine-tuning the details. People have been making what might seem like insignificant adjustments, getting up a half hour earlier, going to bed 15 minutes earlier, flip-flopping perhaps when they exercise and when they eat. Those small adjustments have ended up making big improvements in some of the people that I've been speaking with. Number five, reviewing the results. Not necessarily every day, perhaps at first, but as time goes on, reviewing the results perhaps week by week has allowed people to ask themselves how they're doing, what they're accomplishing, and gives them an opportunity to look at what their evolving needs and desires are in this uncertain time. By doing a review, you give yourself an opportunity to see what you're doing, what you're not, and what you'd like to change. Finally, just some ideas on things to include in a daily schedule: cooking or baking, exercise, meditation and introspection, check-ins with loved ones, check-ins with friends you haven't talked to in a while, self-care, fun and games, and gratitude. Okay, stay safe, keep following precautions with social distancing and droplet precautions, and keep smiling.